Hello scientists, this is Scientific Illustrator John and welcome to Draw About Mad. This video I will talk about the story of how I quit my research job and become a scientific illustrator. I just recently got interviewed by a Dutch magazine, a scientific magazine, and about this craft and how I transitioned from a clinical researcher to an artist, essentially. Since I already done the interview, I also think it would be fun to make a video and have a chat with you guys and to tell you about my dramatic career change. So first of all, about my background, I had a bachelor degree in life science, which is essentially pre-med. And right after I received my bachelor's degree, I was really lucky that I get to work at the National Health Research Institute in Taiwan at the Neuropsychiatric Center on a project that is researching the heroin addiction treatment. The atmosphere is really nice, and the principal investigator is such a nice person, very supportive of everybody in the lab, and also very encouraging people to pursue their academic career. And without any really drastic change, I would probably go on and pursue a PhD and or medical school probably. So after working there for 3 years, I started to become depressed about research job. Not because it's not a good job, because after being a co-author of a few publications and really see the process of how academic research works, I've become frustrated with how much time are us scientists invested into the research and the publishing, and in the end, our articles are only read on average by 3 to 4 people. That is really insane. It's like 5 years of our life put into this project, and then very few people can appreciate it. And also at the same, can't really talk about it with your friends and your family. It's just these academic terms and how the science is published just is not very comprehensible for people who does not work in the field. Then it was a coincidence that I saw there's an article on Nature. They were covering this profession called biomedical illustrator, and it looks quite fun. It's just like really out of nowhere, this idea came into my mind that, oh, it would be nice to do something like that. You know, like combining art and science. But the problem is, I have never actually drawn before. So it was really a crazy idea. I have no idea where it comes from. But then I started taking drawing classes after work. So I basically started from scratch, like drawing the plaster cases, the very geometric, simple ones, you know, like cylinders, sphere and pyramid, that kind of stuff. So like after a few months, I realized that, oh my god, these graphic sketching is taking so long, and I got so frustrated. So and then I took a step back from the work that I was drawing, and then I realized, oh, looking from afar, it looks very, very realistic, like photorealistic. So, and that was like an epiphany to me at that moment. I realized, I can actually do this. So I changed my research job to a part-time position, and then I moved back to Taipei to go to the best art school in Taiwan. They have these classes for people like from outside of the university to take some studio classes over there as hobbies. But my aim was to really develop a portfolio and into applying for scientific illustration programs. Then I met a really great artist teacher over there, like our style and communication is just really compatible, and she taught me how to use colors and also drawing in pastels and oil painting techniques. So that helps me tremendously. I improved very quickly under her supervision, and so the entire process took a year and a half until I prepare a portfolio and then apply for a scientific illustration program. I applied for the one in Canada and then also the ones in Europe, and there were some very funny situation happening in between, but I can talk about it in a different video. If you're interested, let me know in the comments. But anyway, in the end, I managed to get into the program in Scotland and also in the Netherlands. Eventually, I picked the one in Maastricht, Netherlands, because I really like their atmosphere when I visited there, and also their teaching technique is very, very aesthetic. They use the atelier model, which is an apprenticeship model that stems in the Renaissance era, like how Rembrandt and Da Vinci taught their pupils. Also, very luckily that I got one of the biggest scholarships in the world from the British Council to support my study. And so you can watch their promotion video here. They make a little film about it. So that was my transition from a clinical researcher to an artist / scientific illustrator. It was a very drastic change in my career path, and I think it was an extremely risky decision. So there are many very big consequences after the switch, and especially after graduation, because no one around me has ever worked as an artist, and I was very ignorant about that when I made the switch, because I just really want to have an art degree. I thought that was really cool. So I haven't thought about how I can make money out of it, or how I can support myself later on. It was a very pure act of romanticism, so out of my love for art. Now I am slowly building my life back again, and I also really like that I have my little own business in Amsterdam and also in Taipei, and I can collaborate with really great researchers. Also designed journal cover, and it was published at the ACS journal, so that was also really nice. So on top of this artistic work, I also had the opportunity to give workshop at University of Oxford and Einstein Center of Neuroscience in Berlin, and also at the university here in Amsterdam, also in Taipei. So that was something that I really enjoy, and also get to visit these great researchers and learn about what they're doing. That can link to why I want to have this chat with you guys, because a lot of my friends who continue pursuing a PhD in biomedical science, they are very anxious, and they also feel a little bit trapped while they're closing to their graduation of their PhD, because they feel like the scientific research world seems to, that the career seems to only leads to these academic career and professorship and publishing, that kind of lifestyle. Here I want to present you that there's other alternatives that you can do to serve science and the science community. To be honest, we need all kinds of people to support science and the development of science, especially during this corona pandemic crisis. We see that science is more important than ever before, and just how difficult it is to get the correct scientific data and information across to the public or to policymakers, or even to your family members, can be extremely challenging. And how we can improve these kind of communication and also getting these scientific research carrying on. We need all kinds of people, all kinds of skills, and all kinds of talent. It is only because when we are studying about biomedical science, we can only see the example of a career path that people made it by being a scientific researcher, a principal investigator in publishing, and also professorship. That is the example that we have. There are also other kinds of career path that supports scientific development. So I do notice along my path of my entrepreneurship as an alternative scientific worker, the alternative career path other than an academic career in science is underdeveloped. I really hope that in the future we can work together to make these things more exciting and into a more established business that can support all kinds of talent in the science community. If you have a hidden talent other than science, then it's a very good adventure to incorporate that into your scientific profession. It's like from my own personal journey, I do experience that once you combine your hidden talent with your science talent, then it's easier to wake up every day and to get into the grind. And, you know, it doesn't feel like you are wasting your time or your life. Really, just becoming more who you are and manifesting what you're here to do, you know, and also at the same time serve the community and a cause that you find meaningful. I think that's a really nice way of living, and I also recommend anyone who are interested in doing that and take the risk and experience the adventure. Yeah, so that's a quick chat about what I have been asked a lot lately, and I hope in some way it can release your stress as a scientific researcher. And also welcome to comment below to have a chat with me just about what is your experience as a scientist at the institute that you're working at, and what is your experience studying your master or PhD or even working as a PI. I do think these information can be great that we flow them around and just make everybody feel a little bit less lonely in our hard journey in pushing science forward. Also, if you're interested in my journey of applying for scientific illustration programs, also like how I reveal my plan, career switch plan to my principal investigator, that was a very stressful talk. And also how I eventually opened a business in the Netherlands and worked my way to support my artistic passion. Just let me know, and I can also talk about it and make a video out of it. That's what I want to have a quick chat with you besides making tutorial videos. And I really enjoyed the conversations with you about these drawing techniques. So I hope everybody can happy draw while mad, and I'll see you in the tutorials.